Hi to all, welcome back to a travel vlog. We had been to Mangalore to my in-laws' place a week back, so putting few here and there videos of our visit. Couldn't capture at all the places, but tried my best wherever I could. Since it might be a lengthy video, putting it in two parts. So a day before leaving is always an hectic day with lots of work like cleaning, ironing and packing. My son enjoying packing sweets to our near and dear ones. He was totally excited as he will be meeting his cousins almost after a year. We started early in the morning after namaz. Traveling early morning takes less time to reach our destination with full of energy. We always prefer to travel early morning. Stopped in between for breakfast. It was only 7:15 and we were very hungry, so having our breakfast. At the end of the ghat section, we found this typical Mangalorean lime soda. It was so refreshing as the weather was too hot in Mangalore. So we have reached Uppinangadi. It's just 40 to 45 minutes away from Mangalore. To reach proper Mangalore, you'll have to travel again 40 to 45 minutes. So now we have reached home. In the evening, the kids were very busy playing while we, the elders, had a chit chat. That's my son riding the two-wheeler with his cousins. Here, the hot water to take bath is lit this way. Water heaters are also used, but taking bath in water which is boiled in firewood is something refreshing. The wood is kept outside this way and inside the bathroom. There is a huge pot. The water is filled from the tap directly and the smoke goes out from this pipe. I find it difficult to walk barefoot nowadays. Maybe it's because we stay in apartment and we don't get a chance. I remember my childhood playing out without sandals, but nowadays a step forward barefoot is impossible. After breakfast, visiting my brother-in-law's farm, his house construction is also going on there. So on the way, we found these toddy palm tree. Now it's the season of these ice apple. You can find lots and lots of these ice apple fruit all over during this season. My co-sister had prepared these coconut laddu. She had bought it to the farm to have it. It was so yummy. In the evening, we had a family get together. Varieties of dishes were bought from each of their house for dinner. It was a family get together with a message of family bonding. A talk on the topic was given by my brother-in-law. My husband's family is a large family with 10 siblings. So any get-together can be considered as a huge program with more than 50 members. After dinner, few games were organized. The next day after lunch, we started to Mangalore, a 45 minutes journey from my in-laws' house. So we visited few relatives on that day and stayed in a sister-in-law's house. So the next morning went on a ride to the place where I had spent my childhood. At times I just go on a round to see how much it has developed. I had put a detailed video on Mangalore last year. You can watch my Exploring Mangalore City vlog from the earlier videos. That's my school. Few more buildings have come up. One thing what I like about Mangalore is there is no need to lock your helmet. Nobody is going to rob it. You can just leave it on your two-wheeler. As usual at Ideal Ice Cream Parlor, I feel a journey to Mangalore is incomplete without having Ideal Ice Cream. You have to try the ice creams over there. A second part video will follow soon. Until then, bye and take care.